Hello and welcome back to Look At after a very long lockdown break. I've been in the studio this morning dusting the set, just making sure that everything is clean and tidy to welcome my guest. And I'm delighted to welcome back to the studio Dave Pop.
Hello.
Friend and local artist.
Yes, that's me.
Lockdown, I mean, you're an artist, so you work in isolation anyway, don't you?
Yeah, so it wasn't a massive big difference for me. I'm in my studio at home on my own most of the time anyway. So the strange thing was my husband was home as well. And I must admit, we both had a lovely time.
Yep. You didn't drive each other mad?
No, I mean, I was in the studio, he was in the dining room. So we sort of had our separate spaces. But we did a lot of dog walking. We did a lot of DIY. And fortunately, nothing bad happened to us or anyone we knew. So it was a lovely sort of relaxing time. And I think because I'm self-employed, you're always thinking, where's the next job coming from? What am I doing next? Even when you're busy, you're still thinking, what's next? And it was a couple of months where we thought, I can't think, I can't plan. So it was actually quite a...
Did it give you a chance to develop new ideas?
It did, yeah, because I think I was planning to have stuff in the festival.
Yes.
And of course that was all cancelled. So I always had some deadlines and I had things I had to finish things by. But because I had all this time, I just sort of really went back to what I enjoyed doing and just started drawing again. And without having to think, I've got to have something finished.
It's been amazing for a lot of people, this, hasn't it?
Yeah.
That lockdown actually re-sparked their creativity, whether it was in the kitchen or with their homes and decorating, or for artists actually painting, and for some people looking through what they'd done in the past and discovering stuff that they'd done.
And just sort of time to experiment with ideas without having to think, I've got to get something finished.
Yeah.
It was just playful and it was like, oh, this is why I started being an artist in the first place, because I actually enjoy drawing.
And of course, you did actually have some commissions for murals during that period.
Yeah, I mean, amazingly, when I thought nothing was going to come in for months, I had a commission off LOM Fashion, which is a fashion house built in Brighton. And that sort of went crazy over Instagram and Facebook and stuff.
Yeah.
And I had quite a few commissions after that for the Pink House and the Farm Tavern, Balanced Brighton.
Yes.
So, yes, I had a sudden influx of work when I was expecting none. So that was very nice to have.
I mean, it's interesting to see your work because your works on canvas are quite contained. And then you have to scale things up for a wall.
Yes.
Did you find that easy or is that a struggle?
I think because I spend so much of my time just drawing, I'm happiest with a brush and I feel quite free and loose. So I mean, obviously you can do the thing where you square things up.
Yeah.
But I think if I just sort of...
So you work...
I've got a little picture here.
Freehand.
The squares, because obviously if you're doing a figure, you want to make sure you've still got the proportions and it's harder to look back when you're on a big scale. I tend to work quite fast and I like to sort of make a mark as soon as I can. And then step back and think, okay. I mean, one of the commissions I had was to do a copy of a David Hockney painting. So that was really different because it was like, see that picture, I just want that, you know.
Was it an absolute copy or was it,
just one,
an interpretation?
It was an absolute copy.
Right.
It was a figure from portrait of an artist, of a man, so, you know, he's staring down to the swimming pool. So he just wanted that figure painted. So that was a really interesting challenge, actually, because it was, you could definitely tell if he was right or wrong. You know, I could...
Yes, absolutely.
I could always look at something else. But it worked out really well, and it was just a good challenge to, like, match colours, make sure everything was right. For example, his head looked very big. He had that sort of big bouffant 70s hairstyle. Yes. So it was like... Well, that's what he's like. But it was good. But, you know, most of the stuff I do, I paint a lot of flowers and, you know, sort of jungly stuff. So it's quite similar to what I do. But if people commission me, I'm happy to do whatever they want. And then I have exhibitions, which I do. This is my own art. This is mine.
I suppose a lot of people will know you from your period designing cakes.
Yes,
which
yeah.
ended a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
Have you felt freed up now you're not dealing with chocolate and icing?
Well, bizarrely, I've actually gone back to making something out of chocolate for this exhibition. Because when it closed down, we were told we could grab anything that was open. So any food products that was already open, we could take home because there was no worth to them. So I took a couple of boxes of chocolate home and I've had them just stored in the flat. And I thought, I think I'll make a chocolate sculpture for this exhibition.
So what have you made?
So I've made a Dionysus, he's about this tall, out of white chocolate. And I hadn't made anything out of chocolate for about, a year and a half.
Yeah.
And as soon as I started, it was like, it was like welcoming an old friend.
And you enjoyed it?
Loved it, yeah.
And of course, this is planning towards a new exhibition, which is down.
Yes.
So it's in the fishing quarter.
Exhibition, Seaside Source.
Lovely.
So that's in the fishing quarter gallery, which is right on the seafront.
Yeah.
It was supposed to be in August, which would have been perfect time for it. But obviously, because of complications and whatever.
Of course.
We've been, it was cancelled, then it was on again, then it was off again. But it's hopefully now it's on for September the 16th to the 22nd.
And is it a compilation of original paintings and prints this time?
Yeah, so there's quite a few prints in this style. So the theme is very seaside Brighton, it's a bit saucy, cheeky.
It wouldn't be a Dave Pop if it wasn't saucy.
Well, of course, and I think that's what Brighton's all about.
Yeah.
And I've also done 7 original paintings, so like this. So I love the sort of Greek myths and all that sort of classical paintings of them.
Yeah.
And I always thought, you're not supposed to look at art and find it sexy, but a lot of these paintings are, because their togas just seem to...
Yes,
they're very slightly revealing and stuff. So
I think quite a lot of art is sexy. I mean, if you look at the Impressionists and Renoir's paintings of them, they're incredibly sexy.
Yeah, so I've sort of taken that idea and I've done sort of versions of sort of classical Greek gods and myths and stuff and sort of painted them in my own style, made them very bright and with sort of... these are sort of fairground patterns you find on the carousel horses and stuff. So it's a combination of those things. So, for example, I've done the god Dionysus outside the pavilion because I think him and the Prince Regent...
Oh, they'd have been best buddies, wouldn't they?
They just sort of fit, when you start thinking about them. And the spirit of Brighton, that sort of hedonistic debauchery. I don't live that lifestyle so much these days.
None of us do. None of us do.
I think that's, in my youth, I certainly enjoyed Brighton to its fullest.
Yeah, yeah. And of course, Brighton has always had this louche
thing.
Yeah. A famous journalist once said that, Brighton looks like a city that's in helping the police with its inquiries.
Yes. And I love the fact that it's glamorous on the seafront, but when you go behind those houses, you see all the sort of higgledy-piggledy fire escapes and...
Yeah, it's what's really lovely. And I love the fact that in our home city, people live in the centre of the city.
Yes.
It's very unlike other cities, which the centre will be commercial, there'll be no residential. Brighton's got residential property right above the shopping mall in the centre.
Yes.
Throughout the city, people live hugger-mugger with the shops.
Yes,
and it does give it a very different atmosphere, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah, and I think it's vital to Brighton because the people gives it the personality.
Yeah.
It's very young, vibrant, and because we have lots of students here, a lot of liberal-minded people, so we're very artsy. So I think,
we're very lucky in that sense. Well, listen, we're going to get into a break, but I see that you've brought your paints with you.
So I have,
hopefully, in the second half, get you doing earn a living, paint something for us. And what do you think you're going to draw?
I'd draw Dionysus.
Lovely.
As he's my favourite character to draw.
Excellent, excellent. Well, we'll be back in a moment. In the break, I think I'll get Dave started and we'll come back to you when he's made some progress. See you then. Look out.
remember, you can keep in touch with us on the various social media channels, Twitter and Facebook, by searching Latest TV. Plus, of course, you can see all our clips and get the latest news at our website, which is www.thelatest.co.uk. We'll see you in just a few minutes.
Hello, welcome back to Lookout. I can't tell you how exciting it is to be in the studio making new Lookout programmes, but even more exciting is having my good friend Dave Pop here painting live now in the studio. How intimidating is that for you? I mean, are you a person that makes mistakes and throws bits of paper on the floor and starts again?
My style is, when I'm starting a painting, I just paint and draw and draw, and I'm not fussy, and I'll just do it again and again and again.
Right.
So it's not, I don't start thinking, right, I've got to get this perfect. I just start and think, let's just get something on the page and see how it goes.
Right. So it's very spontaneous then.
Yeah, and I think what I tend to do is I draw and draw and draw the same sorts of things over and over again.
Yeah.
So you sort of learn habits and you have how to draw things and
yeah.
It just sort of becomes second nature then.
And does it still give you pleasure, or do you get tense? I mean, I know a lot of artists, and they get so wound up by their work, and you know they stress and struggle and think, oh, this is terrible, and it's not going the way I want it to go. You seem really relaxed to me.
The beginning parts are always lovely. So when you're just starting out and playing with ideas, and you don't really know what you're doing, you're just messing around and doing stuff. That's the lovely, exciting part. And then once you've actually finished a painting, that's very satisfying.
Yes.
But I would say now that's sort of like, that's almost like 20% of the work, because the other 80% of the work is then printing it and photographing it and telling people about it and trying to organise exhibitions and trying to organise publicity. You know,
And 99% of the work has been done between you growing up as a child, going to art school and the experience you gain. And I think a lot of people never account for that. I know as a designer myself, people say, well, how long did it take you?
Exactly,
and I said, well, I suppose I started when I was 18.
Yeah.
Really. And it's taken all those years and you're buying into that experience.
Yeah.
It's not something, and let's make it very clear that this is a sketch. So you're doing something very quickly here for the purposes of the programme, which is fun. But a real painting would take an awful lot longer than this.
My paintings actually tend not to take that long because by the time... So these ones, by the time I've done it, I've done it so many times beforehand...
You're ready.
There's very few brush marks there, you know. It's every brush mark sort of makes a difference. I'm not there doing that.
Yeah, yeah.
I use brushes that you paint the walls with.
There's a level of confidence in your work that
doesn't
come easy, though. I mean, it's come through years and years of doing this, practicing.
Yeah, but it's the constant practice.
Yeah.
It's the constant just, like, holding the brush. And I love, you know, the shapes it makes. There is not a consistent line. You know, you get thick parts, thin parts, how much pressure you use, all things like that.
I can remember very clearly one of my tutors at Chelsea taking a paintbrush out of my hand and telling me to do what I see you do. And that is not hold it up at the ferrule, up at the top, but actually use it in extension so you lengthen your arm by the length of the paintbrush.
Yeah, yeah.
And it gives you a more fluid line. I mean, it changed the way I drew back then.
Yeah, and I think this is...
I'm going to be very quiet watching some of this, and it's great that you can actually see him doing this live. It's wonderful.
He's one of my favourite subjects, Dionysus. And I think, you know, the Greek gods in general, I was always obsessed by them as a child.
Yeah.
And, you know, you sort of go through phases of doing things, and it was quite nice to go back to something...
That fascinated you.
Yeah, and it's like, Of course, I'm still fascinated by them, and I've loved going back to them and, you know, reading their stories again. And I think they had a massive influence on me, because obviously you could... There are lots of beautiful illustrations and paintings depicting the myths. There are always a bit saucy, and there are always these beautiful gods with togas that have slipped a little bit and that sort of thing. Okay. And I think as a child, it was always very fascinating for me.
Yeah. I love the stories about the fact that the Victorians, when they were dealing with the beautiful Greek sculptures and Roman sculptures, went round with a toffee hammer and knocked the genitals off them.
Yeah.
And apparently in the Victorian Albert Museum, there are chests full of drawers full of genitals.
Yes, yeah.
So want to see them, don't you? You want to pop in there.
I know.
Show us your drawers of willies. It takes shape so quickly and so confidently.
And I quite like, you know, I've got this colour palette, it was just like a child's palette. But it's quite nice that you've only got those eight colours.
Now, do you buy the same set of paints all the time? And are they always in production?
These have lasted quite a while.
Because I know when you...
I know I don't have a huge range of colours.
No.
I stick to quite, you know, yellow, red, green, blue, black and white.
Primaries and secondaries.
Yeah.
Normally.
And then I usually sort of... If I'm doing a mural or something... Then I will mix the colours up beforehand.
Right.
Because that's
you need
just sort of saves more time. When you're actually on site, you don't be mixing up colours. Yeah. But when I'm at home, yeah, it's quite nice just to...
I've been watching a lot of documentaries about artists over lockdown on YouTube, and it's been fascinating listening to them talking about the pigments that they used and how at certain points in history things went out of use and came into use and how they can actually tell if it is real by analysing the pigments. And you just think, I wonder what would happen if you became so obsessed with one set of artists' materials and they suddenly stopped making them. You know, if Winsor & Newton went out of business.
Oh, yes,
and so on.
Yeah, because I did this mural for a place called the Pink House that actually create their own range of paint. And it's for, you know, painting outside of walls and stuff. But the pink they've created is the pinkest pink I've ever seen.
Is it this?
And that's what I've used, so yes.
It is a great pink, isn't it?
It's incredible.
Yeah.
And so, once I started using that...
They look like the peppermint chew bars I had as a kid. They were that pink.
Yes, yeah.
And, you did wonder what they were doing to your insides,
yeah.
Because I'm sure they were using all sorts of terrible chemicals when I was growing up. That is incredible to do something so spontaneously and so beautiful. I mean, it's just lovely.
Ah, thank you very much.
You can pop it in the show, can't you?
I can, yes.
Either that or I can distract it and steal him when he's not looking. It's
I'll sign it for you and you can have it as a...
Oh, God, you are very kind. Now, the show... When does it open?
OK, it's September the 16th to the 22nd in the Fishing Quarter Gallery, so that's right on the seafront by, you know, where they sell the cockles and mussels and all that sort of thing. It's open from 10 till 6 every day. I'll be there, so come in and say hello.
You're going to be there all the time?
Yeah, because it's only there for a week.
Yeah.
So unless I've popped out to buy some lunch or something, I'm going to be there. All the time.
Now, you've got editions of the prints.
Yes, so there's...
There's affordable.
Yes, there's going to be posters and postcards. They'll start about £5. Then there's small canvases, which would be about 35. G-clay prints are about 75. Go up to big prints. And, you know, the paintings will be in about a couple of hundred, so...
You've never been expensive, have you? You've actually made it always very affordable.
The paintings are, you know, the most expensive part.
Yeah.
But I think, obviously, there's going to be a lot of passing trade there. And I think it's nice if you can buy something for a fiver.
I always think it's worth having things that are affordable.
Yeah.
And they're so lovely. They really are.
And I've even done a range of T-shirts and stuff, because I think...
Oh, fantastic.
Have my own merchandise store.
T-shirts. Have you made them at grown-up sizes?
I have, yes.
Because I find it very upsetting if I buy a T-shirt which is an XXL, and I get home and it still doesn't fit.
Yes, I have, because I'm quite a grown-up size now after lockdown.
We do, don't we? We spread. Listen, it's been fantastic having you in here. Painting Live is, I put you on the spot, but you've lived up to it. It's absolutely beautiful. The paintings are beautiful. I mean, do try and get down there. It is going to be a fabulous exhibition. It speaks Brighton in every sense. It's saucy, it's seaside, and it's fun. I'm going to come along.
Fantastic.
As ever. And I might even add something to my collection. I've already got one of Dave's. I've got two of Dave's paintings.
Oh.
I've got a drawing and a painting.
Oh, there you go.
So there you go. Might have to have another one. I think we're running out of time, sadly, Dave. It's beautiful. Thank you so much. And I'll see you down on the beach.
Yeah, thank you very much for asking me.
Pleasure. Thank you for watching Lookout. It's lovely to be back and lovely to have you back watching. I'll be back in a week's time with another programme. They're only going to be 30 minutes for the foreseeable future because I can only have one guest at a time. But for now, it's good night. Good night. Lookout. Lookout. We're here for you.